Now, Ethiopia has made significant progress towards improving the health of mothers and babies. That's according to the WHO. However, progress around saving newborns is much slower. Dr. Abeba Bekele is chief of party and newborn health advisor with USAID's flagship maternal and child survival program. She discusses efforts made to further improve maternal and childhood health in Ethiopia.
Ethiopia has made a lot of progress over the past two decades in terms of reducing both maternal and child deaths, child mortality, but the rate of decline in terms of newborn mortality was very, very slow. So currently, newborn mortality is about 29 per 1,000 live births. So when you change that mortality to total population, it translates to about 80,000 annual newborn deaths, neonatal deaths means in the first months of life. So that is huge number. And this is compounded by the fact that a lot of deliveries still happen at home. Mm-hmm. About 70% of deliveries currently are at home in unhygienic condition, rural communities, less literacy, so that complicates it.
So what is the cause why many women give birth at home?
There are several reasons for that. There are cultural and traditional reasons. For example, women would like to have their family support, to be surrounded by family members when they give birth, and our facilities may not be conducive for that. In addition to that, it's access to the service may not be good, cost of care, not only direct cost of the service, but mm-hmm. also opportunity costs. So it's a lot of social, cultural, traditional, as well as economic related problems that prevent women from going to facilities.
So now, what are the key strategies that you have used to improve these issues?
The government understands that newborn mortality is very high and takes that very seriously. It's a key priority of the health sector transformation plan. It's a 5-year plan we're currently implementing. As part of that, the Maternal and Child Survival Program and its predecessor supported the government to try to see if community-based newborn care can be done using the health extension workers we have in Ethiopia. So we have been able to demonstrate that we can train health extension workers and they can do newborn care at community level. So if the caretakers cannot come to the facilities, we need to go to them. So using that approach, we supported the government of Ethiopia to develop, to come up with a community-based newborn care strategy, mm-hmm. which brings the service very closer to the family. So health extension workers, these are primary health care workers that are based in the villages, are trained to identify women early in their pregnancy, follow them through their pregnancy period, promote facility delivery, but when that is not possible, support them during the home birthing process, and then identify the newborns immediately after birth and provide the support that the newborn needs during the day of birth as well as in the subsequent days, especially in the first week of life.
Really an integrated approach. So what kind of impact have you seen?
So in terms of the maternal and child survival program, we really, alongside the providing the service, we really focused on community empowerment. Okay. And we've seen that paying off. So from the evaluations we did, we have seen that mothers-in-law are less fatalistic now of newborn survival. They allow their daughters-in-law to go to facilities for pregnancy checkup, even delivery and postnatal care. Husbands are also have better knowledge of maternal and newborn care. They encourage their wives to go to antenatal care early on, from the first trimester. We've also seen that women have now better self-efficacy in terms of really engaging in maternal, newborn, and child health issues.